and subtract polynomials. Problem number 3. Add. So we have 1/6 s^3 minus 1/3 s^2 plus 3/2 s plus 6, and all that is added to 2/3 s^3 power plus 2/3 s^2 power plus 5/2 s and plus 2/5. So because there's an addition sign in the middle, we can just drop the parentheses and combine like terms. Like terms are variables with the same degree, the same exponent, and we can just add their coefficients together. So in this case, we have s^3 in the first set of parentheses and s^3 in the second set. So what we do is we just add their coefficients together. And because in this step I just want to focus on combining like terms, I will deal with the fractions later. So we add the coefficients, which is 1/6 plus 2/3. And this term is keeping the same variable and the same exponent because they were like terms. Now we are moving on to the next term, which is s^2, and we do have a like term, which is also s^2. Again, we are going to add their coefficients together. So we have -1/3 plus 2/3, and both of these have the same variable and exponent. Our next term is just s, and again we have two like terms. Let's add their coefficients. And they stay with the same variable. Last is the constant, and they are also like terms. So we are going to just add these two numbers together. Okay, in the next step, we will be dealing with the fractions, and when you are adding or subtracting fractions, you need the same common denominator. In our first case, these two fractions have different denominators, so we need to find the least common. The least common denominator is a number that both of these denominators would multiply into, or a better way of understanding is it is a number that both of these divide evenly. So the least common would be 6, because 6 goes into 6 evenly one time, and 3 goes into 6 evenly two times. Because this is already 6, we can just leave it as is. But this, we have to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. This gives us 2 times 2, which is 4, and 3 times 2, which is 6. Now, these two terms can be added together. Because they have the same common denominator now, we can just add the numerators. So 1 plus 4 is 5/6. And don't forget your variable with the power that needs to come down. So this term has added together to give us 5/6 s³. Now, looking at the next term, we already have the same common denominators, so we can just add the numerators without doing this extra step. -1 + 2 gives me a +1. So +1, and the denominator stays the same, and we have our variable with the power of 2. Our next part also has the same common denominator, so we basically just add the numerators together. 5 + 3 gives me 8 over 2. And I'm going to write this here because 8 over 2 can be simplified. Both of these numbers have a common divisor, and in this case it's 2, so 8 divided by 2 is just 4. So our final answer would be 4s. In the last part, we can make the whole number a fraction as well by putting it over 1. And now we can see that the denominators are not the same. We have to find the least common denominator. And the least common denominator would be 5, because 1 goes into 5 5 times, and 5 goes into 5 1 time. So because this side already has the least common denominator, we leave it alone, but this side has to be multiplied, numerator and denominator, by 5. Now, 5 times 6 gives us 30, and 5 times 1 is 5. And the second one, we said we are going to leave it alone. And now we can see how both of these have the same common denominator, and we add the numerators, so we get plus 32 over 5. Which we cannot simplify, they do not share a common factor. So if none of these terms are like terms any longer, and all of the fractions are simplified to lowest terms, this is our final answer for this problem.